Tony Bland joins us on the Western Exterminator Hotline. Tony, great to speak with you. How's life these days?
Life is great, guys. How's it going?
Doing well over here.
Doing really well. Now, do you have a reputation now when you walk into a high school gym where people know who you are?
Yeah, I mean, kind of like, you know, Steve Fisher and Coach K and all that. They think of me the same way. They see me coming and they want autographs. No.
I was like, what?
I love it.
I'm not going to cut you off.
I know. That's why I was like, wait, go ahead. Keep on talking.
Keep
then.
On going. I love it.
The modern day Phil Jackson.
No, but in all honesty, I know you can be modest, but here in the Southern California region, Tony, when you walk into a high school gym, do people really know, hey, Tony Bland is here? Because you've developed a reputation as one hell of a recruiter.
Yeah, I think it's more, to answer your question, yeah, but I think it's more of what our program has done. It's more San Diego State has walked in the building. You know, I think if we have you walk in the building with a San Diego State shirt on, they're going to be like, oh, there you go, guys.
Yep.
I just think it's where our program is at this point, that everyone is excited when we walk in.
Tony, I know you're making your name as a very good recruiter. I just kind of want to know, in your mind, Midnight on the Mesa, Midnight Madness, if you will, how much of a recruiting tool do you think that is?
Hey, guys, first, I have to tell you this. When I first came here, I dreamed about Midnight Madness.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, there's Madness on the Mesa, which is going to be awesome. When I was here, when I first got here, I was just mad at Midnight. There was no excitement like it is right now. This place is going nuts. The whole West Coast is talking about it. Guys, everybody from L.A., everybody want to be a part of it. It's going to be insane.
Good.
Describe it a little bit. I know the element of surprise is still fun, but when you say it's going to be insane, give us a little rundown.
Okay, we have, in my opinion, some of the best dunkers in college basketball.
Agreed.
You know, they'll be on display. Our women have very skilled, talented players. They'll be on display. And in general, basketball season is coming. You know, we're doing this. We're putting the uniforms on. We're out there. The music, the fans, that just lets you know that basketball season is around the corner, and that's what we're really excited about.
Tony, you know, one of the things we were talking about this team, you already have some guys who are incumbent or already here who are very good, and you have Winston Shepherd and some other guys coming in who are very good themselves. And we talked about just the blending of personalities and egos working as a team. I just wonder, the coaching staff, you are the younger guy in that coaching staff, maybe talk the language with the players a bit more than the coaches. Do you kind of view yourself as the go-between, the type of guy who can communicate with the players maybe even better than some of the coaches?
I think I do a great job at bridging the gap. Well, Coach Fisher, I don't think he'd give everybody his right there. He has to be in his early 30s with the way he relates to the guys.
Sure.
You know, but I think I do a great job of bridging the gap because, you know, I'm not far removed from where they are. And, yeah, I mean, it's luckily we have some great guys, so we don't need any gap bridging. You know, we just, you know, they really take to what the coaching staff says, Coach Dutcher and Little Fisher, and we just, you know, they do a great job of just doing the things that they need to do.
Madness on the Mesa tomorrow at Viejas Arena. Aztecs assistant coach Tony Bland joining us on San Diego Sports Leader XX 1090. Tony, we've all played basketball outside. All of the players on this team have played basketball outside, outdoors. But how much of a challenge is it going to be against Syracuse? Not just facing Syracuse, but the depth perception, being on that aircraft carrier. How much of a challenge do you think that'll be?
I think it'll be a pretty big challenge. Obviously, you know, they're a zone team. And, you know, zone forces you shoot the ball. And we don't know what the weather's going to be like that day. We might have a couple going to the water. But other than that, once we get it together, I mean, I think they're a great team. The second favorite team I've ever played for.
And, well said.
I think they'll do a good job of making the shoot jumpers, but I think we'll adjust well. Maybe we can go find the court outside and get a week of practice in so we can have our stuff together by the time we play.
See, that's what I was going to ask you, Tone, because you hear football teams, they'll talk about, well, we're going to a loud environment, so let's pump up some music and play it during practice so the guys can kind of get used to having all that type of noise. Do you think Coach Fisher will bring the boys outside for a little street ball just to kind of get the feel of playing outside as a team?
I hope so, because it's a little elementary school around the corner, and I might be able to dunk if we go outside.
Oh, man, so what are you saying? For a 10-foot rim, you still don't have it anymore? You can't get the hops on?
Come on, Tony.
A 10-foot rim. I will be the best guy at getting hung you ever met.
You're still tapping backboard? You tap the backboard, though, right?
I can still tap for sure. We can have a tap contest.
Hey, Tony, last year, if you ask the question, who's the leader of this team, the answer would be Tim Shelton. I know it's a total team effort, but Tim Shelton was just that veteran elder statesman. Does this team have one leader? Is there one single guy you look to?
You know what? I just actually talked to Tim Shelton about this. I look at this team. Do you remember that the Detroit Pistons team that were you know, with Chauncey Billups and Rip Hamilton.
Sure.
And who was the leader of that team?
Don't know.
You don't know. And I think that's what we have here. I think we have a group of guys, veteran guys that have been around the block that are really responsible and that really want to win. And we'll have different leaders in different areas, and they'll step up at different times. So I like to think of that's how we are with this team.
And how about, we'll talk about Tim Shelton. How about Tim? How's he doing? I know he's working with you guys. When I think he has a brilliant coaching future in his future if he wants to do that. How's he working out so far?
He's doing great. He's doing great. Every time, you know, it's a tough day and it is down, I say, hey, Tim, why don't you kick a freestyle for me or something? So he's great. He's great to have around. He has a really good basketball mind. You know, he's under the Steve Fisher tutelage just like all the rest of us. So he'll be great one day at coaching, and hopefully sooner than later.
Aztecs assistant coach Tony Bland, he'll be there tomorrow for Madness on the Mesa. Tony, do you care about preseason accolades? We're looking at all these magazines and newspapers saying where they see the Aztecs, picking the Aztecs, rankings. Do you ever care about that?
I mean, it's always fun for the guys to see and always for us to see. And obviously, you know, going out recruiting, it's always a good tool. But all that matters is that the postseason accolades, you know, who won the last game, and, you know, who did what you're supposed to do. The guys that were projected to do well, who really did well. So, I mean, I think we're looking forward to that. And, you know, preseason things is fun. It's always one of those refreshing things, but
yeah,
it doesn't really mean much, you know.
Especially this year, it's going to be fun. Final question, Tony. We know we'll be talking to you as the season progresses, but this is putting you on the spot. Who is the best dunker on this team? Who do you expect to emerge as the dunk champ?
Okay.
It's tough.
That is a tough question because can I break it down in
please.
Two parts?
Yeah, please.
Please.
Because I would say the highest jumper on the team, hands down, is Dwayne Poley. I think he's in a different atmosphere when he jumps. He can probably touch his head on the scoreboard, you know. But I think the best dunker has to be Jamal Franklin. He has, like, show dunks. Like, when he was a kid, he was bored, so he would just go practice different things. You know, and I think he's a gym rat. So I think he have a couple tricks up his sleeve right now that he might pull out. So I'm going to have to give it to him.
I love it. It's going to be so much fun.
The sleeper pick, though, is Deshaun Stevens. And if you guys didn't realize what I did, I just picked the whole field. So
that's my method also. But if you want to actually see it go down tomorrow, 9 p.m. at Viejas Arena,